Every time you cough, sneeze, or talk, you produce these respiratory droplets. That's how the CDC says the coronavirus is passed on to the next person.
Yeah, it's a little bit scary. That's been the developing information over the past few weeks. It's kind of come to a head now. Lauren Day joins us now with more on just how a simple cloth mask can actually help. Lauren.
That's right. The CDC now recommends you wear a cloth mask like this or a face covering when you leave your home. But how exactly does this help? I spoke with a doctor to find out, and I met an Oahu woman who's giving away homemade masks for free. Pamela Medeiros works a full 8-hour shift from home, and then she works some more.
At 3:30, I actually get something to eat and drink, and then I go right into sewing.
Wow.
And I sew until like 6 o'clock in the morning.
She's sewing masks all night long.
And I want them to be able to protect them and their families, so that's why I'm giving it away.
But why are we now being told to wear cloth masks in public? It's because experts are learning more about the virus.
We've also learned that there is a lot more asymptomatic spread than we originally thought. And so what that means is somebody like you or me, who does not have any symptoms whatsoever, could be spreading the virus.
To put what Dr. Rupi said into perspective, pretend this spray bottle with dyed water is the droplets that come out of your mouth. Every time you cough, sneeze, or even talk, your droplets that could contain the coronavirus land on surfaces around you. Then let's say someone comes up, touches the same surface, and then immediately rubs their face. Now that person has just been exposed to the virus.
By just by talking, they can go up to 3 to 6 feet.
Dr. Rupi asked the public to save N95 masks for healthcare workers and make sure you're using proper hygiene.
You should be washing a cloth face mask after every single use, but also making sure that you're using adequate hand hygiene, because I'm seeing folks not using their masks appropriately or not particularly being careful about washing hands before putting on or taking off.
But remember,
wearing face masks should not be promoting folks to go out into public, because the best way to avoid this altogether is to stay at home.
Even though it's not fail-proof, Medeiros is sewing throughout the night so you can have some protection. Dr. Rupi adds that when you take off your mask, grab the elastic by your ears. That way, you're not touching your nose or your mouth. We'll put all this information and where you can get a cloth mask on our website, khun2.com. Lauren Day, KHUN2 News, working for Hawaii. Back to you in the studio.